I want to thank all those Nova Scotians who've continued to follow the public health advice and the businesses like grocery stores that have remained open and are taking extraordinary measures to protect the public and their employees while helping slow the spread of this virus. But today, I need to focus on those who are not following public health advice. Over the weekend, I saw and heard of far too many incidents of people gathering, blatantly disregarding the social and physical distance rules of staying 6 feet or 2 meters apart. Hundreds gathering on our beaches and in our parks, large groups of people congregating, young people playing street hockey, cars parked everywhere, people disregarding law enforcement. We are dealing with a deadly virus, and this behavior is unacceptable. And so today, effective immediately, I am declaring a provincial state of emergency. Minister Porter is here to explain what that means, and Minister Fury is here to explain how we will enforce it. We are also reducing the size of gatherings effective immediately. People cannot gather in groups of more than five. You can still go outside, but you walk to exercise, not to socialize. Stay in your neighborhood, walk around the block, or down the street. Our provincial parks are closed. If you go there, you are trespassing and your vehicles will be towed. You can get groceries, you can go to the pharmacy, but do not do it in packs. Identify a single family member who can do those errands. And if you are an individual helping neighbors, please continue to do so. We are working with our municipal leaders and our First Nation leaders. It is imperative that all of us follow the state of emergency and use common sense. Currently, if you've traveled outside of Canada, you must self-isolate for 14 days. We are now taking this to a new level. Effectively tomorrow, the borders of Nova Scotia will be tightened. As of 6 a.m., if you have traveled anywhere outside of Nova Scotia, you must self-isolate for 14 days when you return. This will be managed at points of entry into our province, the ferries in Digby and North Sydney, our airports in Halifax and Sydney, and our land border with New Brunswick. We are making exceptions for those who provide essential service, including trucking, health care, child protection workers, and law enforcement. If you are coming into our province, you will be stopped at every entry point, questioned, and told to self-isolate. For those who are not essential service and want to enter our province for social purposes, please stay home. This decision was not made lightly, but we must continue to act and use every tool available to flatten the curve and reduce the spread of COVID-19 in our communities and the virus' significant impact on our healthcare system. We have a social responsibility to focus on the public good. A failure to follow public health guidelines to limit the spread of COVID-19 puts our civil liberties at risk. We have no choice but to put more stringent measures in place to contain people to their own homes and to help prevent the spread of COVID-19. Each of us has a moral and legal obligation to ensure that we adhere fully to the orders and advice of our chief medical officer, and there will be no exceptions. I will now turn to Minister Porter to explain what this order means.
Thank you, Premier. This declaration of a province-wide state of emergency underlines the seriousness of the current situation as it relates to COVID-19 and enables the province to enforce its directives. The Emergency Management Act gives us the authority to further protect the health and safety of Nova Scotians and to provide for the broader public good. The state of emergency does not replace the powers of the Chief Medical Officer of Health. Instead, this order extends the province's authority and adds to the important work that has already been done. Under this order, government can control or prohibit assembly as well as travel to and from areas. The order also provides the authority needed to coordinate commerce, activity, and emergency responders so we can ensure people are safe. We need all Nova Scotians to appreciate the seriousness of this virus and the harm that it can cause. Now is the time to follow the direction of our public health officials and support each other and our neighbors. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister Porter. Now I'll ask Minister Fury to explain how we will enforce this order.
Thank you, Premier. Upon the recommendation of Dr. Strang, we are taking immediate action to authorize police to enforce orders under the Health Protection Act related to both self-isolation and social distancing. The Health Protection Act authorizes the Chief Medical Officer to request police assistance to enforce his orders. This means that people and businesses will now face fines for violations or orders made under the Health Protection Act. Many Nova Scotians have taken Dr. Strang's advice and are following the order to self-isolate. However, as the Premier indicated, many are not. We therefore have no choice but to call upon the police and law enforcement community to enforce self-isolation and social distancing. In addition, effective today, social distancing will also now form part of the Chief Medical Officer's order, and police are also now authorized to enforce this order. Starting immediately, police now have the authority to issue summary offense tickets to people who are not adhering to Dr. Strang's order to self-isolate or adhere to social distancing. The fines under the Health Protection Act are for individuals found in breach of the order, $1,000 for each fine for each day. And for businesses and corporations, $7,500 in the first instance and for each subsequent day. People can be fined on multiple days if they fail to comply with the law. Police and law enforcement have been notified of these enforcement measures and are ready to begin implementation today. We've engaged our police leadership. They have requested and we are able to respond to provide them this level of authority. And I want to take this opportunity to thank the men and women in uniform who are on the front line. And as the Premier indicated, their efforts and actions yesterday were dismissed. They now have the authority to fine and arrest if necessary. Thank you, Premier.
Thank you, Minister Fury. And now I'll ask Dr. Strang to update you on the COVID-19 cases here in our province.
Thank you, Premier and Ministers. Today we're announcing 7 new cases of COVID-19, and like earlier cases, they are either travel-related or close contacts of previously announced cases. At this point, none are related to local community spread. This brings the total to 28 cases of COVID-19 in Nova Scotia and 13 between yesterday and today. The individuals affected range from people in their upper teens to into their 70s, and cases have been identified in communities across the province. Public health, every time we have a confirmed case, public health rapidly moves in, understands where that individual has been at the time they could have been infectious, and identifies all contacts and works closely with those contacts to put them in self-isolation for a 14-day period. And if there are community exposures, like you've heard in the last couple of days of the basketball tournament, we make public announcements, but as much as possible, we work with individuals and their families behind the scenes to ensure contacts are in isolation. We've had almost 2,100 total tests done here in Nova Scotia, and I'm pleased to be able to announce that today at the QE2 Health Sciences Center Microbiology Lab is now able to report both positive and negative tests for COVID-19 as confirmed. This is a good thing. Our tests will no longer have to be sent to the National Microbiology Lab for confirmation, and it will speed up the ability to let people know the status of their test results. As you've heard, and as I've said before, there are no cases right now that are related to community spread. However, as we continue to have cases occurring in Nova Scotia, we can expect that we will soon see this occurring. That is why we're taking the actions that have been announced earlier.